Yes, good morning students. Last video we had done, we had completed all the four colligative properties. These colligative properties are used to determine molecular masses of solute. So what are the methods for determining molecular mass of solute? First colligative property used for determining molecular mass is relative lowering of vapor pressure. Relative lowering of vapor pressure. और कैसे डिटरमाइन करते हैं इससे P1 नॉट माइनस P1 अपॉन P1 नॉट दिस इज रिलेटिव लोअरिंग ऑफ वेपर प्रेशर दैट इज इक्वल टू W2 बाय N2 इनटू N1 अपॉन W1 दिस इज मॉलिक्युलर मास ऑफ सॉल्यूट सो हाउ टू डिटरमाइन मॉलिक्युलर मास M2 वुड बी W2 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय M1 अपॉन टेक दिस क्वालिटेटिव प्रॉपर्टी हियर माइनस P1 अपॉन P1 नॉट मल्टीप्लाइड बाय So this is first method for calculating molecular mass of solute by using relative lowering of vapor pressure. Second is elevation in boiling point. Elevation in boiling point. How to determine molecular mass from elevation in boiling point? Delta TB is W2 by M2 into 1000 by W1. Yesterday we had derived multiplied by Kb. Kb is molar elevation constant. This is molecular mass of solute. So how to determine molecular mass? M2 can be determined by W2 multiplied by Kb multiplied by 1000 divided by delta Tb into W1. So this is the colligative property and this is the molecular mass of solute. Third method was depression in freezing point. How to determine molecular mass from depression in freezing point method? Delta Tf equals W2 by M2 into Kf into 1000 by W1. So, isse kaise nikalenge molecular mass? So, M2 will be W2 Kf into 1000 upon Delta Tf multiplied by W1. So, by using depression and freezing point also we can calculate molecular mass of solute. Fourth method is osmotic pressure method. In osmotic pressure method, how to determine molecular mass? Pi is equals to W2 by M2 RT by V. So how to determine molecular mass by the use of colligative property? M2 is determined by W2 RT upon pi into V. So there are four colligative properties used to determine molecular mass of solute. Okay. Now out of these four properties, osmotic pressure method is best. Chare mathi pi. Ena thi tame ene use karine jo molecular mass find karo, e best chhe. For determining molecular mass of solute. For polymers, eva solute hoy jena molecular mass bahu high hoy. Biomolecules che. E loko mate osmotic pressure method best hoy che out of these four methods. Kyunki hum osmotic pressure mein molarity use karte hain. Aur baki ke teen method hai usme molarity use hota hai. And molarity is what we call more authentic compared to molality. So in calculating osmotic pressure, we are using molarity. So this method is best out of four for determining molecular mass of solute. Charo use kar sakte hain, but charo mein se best hai for biomolecule, for polymer, pehle jena molecular mass is bahut high ho, ena mate kyu method best che, that is osmotic pressure method. Now, the last topic of the chapter, that is abnormal molecular mass. There are two types of solutes. अब तक जो हमने सोल्यूट पढ़े वो सब नॉन इलेक्ट्रोलाइट और नॉन वॉलेटाइल एवा सोल्यूट्स है लाइक यूरिया पछी ग्लूकोज C6H12O6 अच्छी सुक्रोज C12H22O11. These type of solutes, they are non-volatile, non-electrolyte. Non-electrolyte means they won't dissociate into what? Into ions. Paani mein dissociate thein ions no banane. Urea, glucose and sucrose. But there are some solutes which dissolve in water and undergo dissociation. Which solutes undergo dissociation? Solutes like NaCl, when dissolved in water, it dissociate to form Na plus NaCl. Salt like KCl, yeah, barium chloride, when dissolved in water, it dissociate to give barium ion and chloride. So when we are dissolving 1 mole NaCl, how many particles will be there in the solution? 2 particles. But in case of urea, if we dissolve 1 mole urea, 1 mole particle will be there in the solution. Because urea won't dissociate. Barium chloride, if it dissolves 1 mole, then how many mole total particles will be there? 3 moles particle. 1 mole barium chloride leads to 2 mole barium ions. Sorry, 1 mole barium ion and 2 mole chloride ion. So total 3 mole particles will be there. And if number of particles will change, colligative property will change. Colligative property change, then molecular masses will not be normal molecular mass. NaCl apne solute ni jem dissolve kari, elevation of boiling point thi enu molecular mass find kari, elevation in boiling point method thi, to anu molecular mass normal enu molecular mass ketlu hoy 58.5 gram per mole. But jare tame ne colligative property use kari ne calculate karso, to enu molecular mass ardhu hoyse 58.5 divided by मतलब abnormal molecular mass है क्यों normal 58.5 है colligative property use करके calculate करते हैं तो why it is abnormal because when it dissolved in water to prepare solution it dissociate to give more particles as particle increase colligative property change colligative property changes so molecular mass calculated by the use of colligative property जो तुम्हें colligative property use करी ने molecular mass find करता हो आवा type नो solute नो कि molecular mass के हुआ वे abnormal आवे due to dissociation what happened? due to dissociation number of particles increase in the solution जैसे NaCl में हमने देखा ना एक volt dissolve किया दो particle मिले इसमें तीन particle मिले ऐसे solute पे depend करेगा number of particle will increase as number of particle increase colligative property change થઈ જશે જો colligative property change થાય એટલે colligative property particle ઉપર depend કરે જો ઈ change થાય એનાથી જો તમે molecular mass calculate કરતા હો તો molecular mass કેવું થઈ જશે change થઈ જશે this change in molecular mass or changed molecular mass is known as abnormal molecular mass so due to dissociation of solute molecular mass that we are calculating by the use of colligative property is not normal, it is abnormal. Second type of solutes are solutes which associate in the solution. Ye sab dissociate hote and there are some which associate in the solution. Association takes place. Jaise acetic acid. When acetic acid dissolved in water, it dissociates into ions CH3COO- and H+. But if acetic acid is dissolved in benzene, toluene, then it will associate. Two particles combine and form dimer CH3COOH hold twice. And this dimer is joined by intermolecular hydrogen bond C double bond. O, CH3COOH આવે રીતના CH3C ડબલ બોન્ડ O OH વન પાર્ટિકલ ધીસ ઇઝ સેકન્ડ વન CH3C ડબલ બોન્ડ O એન્ડ OH દો મોલેક્યુલ દે આર જોઈન્ડ બાય ઇન્ટર મોલેક્યુલર હાઇડ્રોજન બોન્ડ એન્ડ ફોર્મ ડાઇમર સો નંબર ઓફ પાર્ટિકલ્સ વિલ ડિક્રીઝ આપણે ડિઝોલ્વ કર્યા બે અને અંદર સોલ્યુશનમાં જઈને કેટલા થઈ ગયા 1 બીકોઝ ઇટ ડાઇમરાઇઝ phenol trimerizes then if it dissolve 3 particles inside it will become one only particle number of particle ocha thai jaye so due to association एसोसिएशन नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स डिक्रीज थे जो लम्बा इंक्रीज था तथा हमारा नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल डिक्रीजेस दस डिसॉल्व कर सो तो यहाँ पांच देखा से पचास डिसॉल्व कर सो तो पच्चीस देखा एसिटिक एसिड बिकॉज एसिटिक एसिड मॉलिक्यूल डाइमराइज ड्यू टू डाइमराइजेशन ड्यू टू डिक्रीज इन नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल मॉलिक्यूल मास डबल थे जाए मॉलिक्यूल मास इंक्रीज थे जाए मतलब अर्धो थे जाए तो डबल थे जाए मतलब मॉलिक्यूल मास डबल मीन्स एबनॉर्मल मॉलिक्यूल मास नॉर्मल करता डबल आ रहा है इसलिए मॉलिक्यूल मास इज एबनॉर्मल मॉलिक्यूल मास सो For solutes which dissociate or the solutes which associates, if such type of solutes we are using in the solution and we are calculating molecular masses by the use of colligative properties, then their molecular masses will be abnormal molecular mass. So how to remove this discrepancy, how to remove this problem, Wenthoff came and gave one expression for this abnormal molecular mass that is known as Wenthoff factor. Wenthoff नाम के साइंटिस्ट ने एक टर्म इंट्रोड्यूस किया उसको बोलते हैं Wenthoff factor. What is this Wenthoff factor? I से डिनोट करते हैं इसको इट इज नॉर्मल मॉलिक्यूलर मास अपॉन एबनॉर्मल मॉलिक्यूलर मास I इज नॉर्मल मॉलिक्यूलर मास अपॉन एबनॉर्मल मॉलिक्यूलर मास इससे आपको I मिल जाएगा I कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड रेशियो ऑफ नॉर्मल मॉलिक्यूलर मास सपोज NaCl वी आर यूजिंग इट्स नॉर्मल मॉलिक्यूलर मास इज 58.5 एंड इफ वी कैलकुलेट बाय यूज ऑफ कॉलिगेटिव प्रॉपर्टी द मॉलिक्यूलर मास कम्स आउट टू बी सपोज 30.6 देन बाय डिवाइडिंग 2 वी कैन हैव I व्हिच इज नोन एज Wenthoff factor કેટલો ડેવિએશન આવે એની પ્રોબ્લેમ છે આમ તો જ્યારે ડિસોસિએશન એસોસિએશન નહીં હોય ત્યારે તો બે મોલેક્યુલર માસ સરખા જ હશે નોર્મલ અને એબનોર્મલ બટ જ્યારે સોલ્યુટ ડિસોસિએટ થશે કા એસોસિએટ થશે તો આ વેલ્યુ આનાથી ડિફર કરશે કેવી આવશે ઓછી આવશે ઓકે ઓર કેસે લખી સકતે આઈ કો નોર્મલ ઓર એબનોર્મલ એબનોર્મલ કાસે મિલતા એક્સપેરિમેન્ટ એક્સપેરિમેન્ટલ કોલિગેટિવ પ્રોપર્ટી એક્સપેરિમેન્ટલ કોલિગેટિવ પ્રોપર્ટી અપોન theoretical colligative on theoretical colligative why inversely undu kem thai gaya because molecular mass and colligative property are inversely related to each other apne jetla formula bhaina delta tb vadu athwa delta tf vada pi lidu tu ema badha ma molecular mass of solute niche avu etle they are inversely related to each other so if it is normal upon abnormal molecular mass that colligative property will be experimental for theoretical. So this way we can determine I. For dissociation, agar solute dissociate ho raha hai, to this I value will be more than 1. Suppose association takes place, in association, I value will be less than 1. And if no association or dissociation, solute is like urea and all, no association, no dissociation, non-electrolyte hoye, je pani ma jaine dissociate associate na thaye, so I will be equals to 1. Okay, so Wenthoff factor we can determine for degree of association and dissociation. Now we introduce this factor in all the four formulas so that the molecular mass will become abnormal. Now it not be abnormal molecular mass. I factor બધા ફોર્મ્યુલામાં ઇન્ટ્રોડ્યુસ કરી દેવાનો કેવી રીતના આપણી પાસે ચાર કોલિગેટિવ પ્રોપર્ટી હતી એને આપણે આવી રીતના હવે યુઝ કરવાની P1 નોટ માઇનસ P1 અપોન P1 નોટ ધેટ ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ I વિચ ઇઝ Wenthoff factor મલ્ટીપ્લાઈડ બાય જે ફોર્મ્યુલા હતું ઈ W2 બાય M2 M1 અપોન W1 ફોર ડેલ્ટા TB ધેટ ઇઝ એલિવેશન ઇન બોઇલિંગ પોઈન્ટ I KB molar. Similarly for delta TF, I KF into molar. For pi osmotic pressure, it is I. Then W2 by M2 into RT by V. So I we have to introduce in all the four terms. By the use of this I, abnormality will be cancelled. Now we will not show the abnormal molecular masses. Okay? Now, suppose NaCl, KCl, this type of solutes are there. Or we have suppose acetic acid in benzene, phenol in benzene, they will associate and these will dissociate. Now we should know the degree of dissociation or association. In next video we will continue with formula degree of dissociation and association.